What's up guys, it's Tommy here and welcome to a brand new Liverpool transfer video. And this is a player reveal video because Liverpool have officially signed a Brazilian teenager wonder goalkeeper Pitaluga from Fluminense in a £2 million deal. So in this video you will get to know him. He is the future Alisson, if you like, because he comes from the same club as Alisson used to play, and he actually was signed by Liverpool because of the glowing recommendation of Alisson. Alisson recommended him to Liverpool, and he won the under 17 World Cup with Brazil in 2019, and he will move to Liverpool and he will link up with the Liverpool under 23 side. So not the first team, but in a few years I think he could be a future number one goalkeeper for Liverpool. And Liverpool have agreed a deal that could cost them up to £2 million, which is $2.6 million for the 17-year-old, and he is arriving in Liverpool to complete a medical and sign his first professional contract. The teenager also holds a German passport, which has enabled him to make a transfer before his 18th birthday. And on his Instagram, he already put Liverpool FC under his bio, and also he shared a picture of him at the Rio de Janeiro airport with the caption, "You will never walk alone." Also in February, he was pictured alongside Alisson and also Alisson's brother Muriel, who is Fluminense's first choice goalkeeper. Pitaluga has been with Fluminense since the age of 7, so he is like a youth academy product. And Goal.com understands that the Brazilian club have negotiated a 25% sell-on clause with Liverpool, so if he ever leaves Liverpool, then Fluminense will get 25% of any transfer fee that Liverpool would get. The initial fees, so the base fee is just £700,000, which is absolute peanuts for a club the size of Liverpool. But there is a further £1.2 million made up of personal performance-related add-ons. Pitaluga didn't make a senior appearance at Fluminense, but he's a very high-rated young goalkeeper. And this is what he said: "I'm very grateful to Fluminense. I was 10 years at this club, from futsal passing through until I reached the professional ranks. I have always been treated very well and had all the assistance necessary for my development, both personally and as an athlete. This support that came up will be very important to me. It was a unique opportunity, mainly for having a European passport." So if you are excited for Liverpool signing another player, leave a like on this video and subscribe if you are new around here. Turn on the bell notifications so you never miss the latest Liverpool transfer news update. And the Liverpool under-23s began their season with a 1-0 win in the Merseyside derby against Everton. Koeman Kelleher started in goal for that game, but also Polish Sots shotstopper is expected to go out on loan to Greek side PAOK. They are the favorites to land Grabara. And Liverpool also added a 16-year-old goalkeeper Fabian Mrozek from Polish outfit FC Wrocław in July, and he will be part of the Liverpool under 18 squad. So the fact that Pitaluga will be the part of the under 23 squad means that he's more talented than his peers. He's more talented than a fellow 17-18 year olds, so I think that is a very, very exciting signing for Liverpool. And what signifies how talented Pitaluga is that the Fluminense fans absolutely are furious, and they are rioting against the club because they actually took to the streets of Rio de Janeiro to express their disapproval of Fluminense's transfer business in the summer. And this comes after Evan Lisson, another promising youngster from Fluminense, was sold to Portuguese giant Porto last week, and Fluminense fans aren't happy one bit. The departure of Pitaluga was seemingly a tipping point for many of the Brazilian club's faithful fans, and they were parading around a huge banner saying "Outlet Fluminense" after the deal was announced. And we can sympathize with those fans, because Liverpool, previously before Jurgen Klopp arrived, we sold some big players like Raheem Sterling, Sterling, Luis Suarez, Fernando Torres, Philippe Coutinho. Liverpool fans were also angry sometimes at the club owners for selling some of our most talented and best players. But we don't know the financial situation of Fluminense as a club, and they are one of the biggest clubs in Brazil, and the fans don't really want to see their biggest talents leave the club. They want them to build for the future and to compete for trophies and titles both in Brazil and also in the Copa America. So I can fully sympathize with the Fluminense fans. And I also have big news to share with you guys. It looks like that Sheffield United have agreed a fee with Liverpool on the transfer or loan deal of Ryan Brewster. Many different sources are saying different things. Some sources are saying that Liverpool are selling Brewster permanently to Sheffield United with a buyback clause inserted into his contract. Others are saying that we are selling him on loan. We are moving him on loan to Sheffield United. And also this article, which was retweeted by James Pierce, who is a well-connected journalist, saying that Sheffield United are in talks to sign Brewster on a loan from Liverpool to address their lack of goals up front. And according to some Liverpool fans, there is an account on Twitter which is quite reliable saying that Sheffield United have agreed a fee with Liverpool for Ryan Brewster's transfer. So at the moment I don't really know who to believe, that it's a loan deal or a transfer. I would trust the journalists more saying it's a loan deal. But I think it's very interesting that Liverpool are trying, of course, to move on as many players as possible, because we might replace Brewster with Ismail Assar, and we might replace the likes of Harry Wilson and Marco Grujic with Thiago. I think the transfer deals will speed up as we are getting closer and closer to the transfer deadline day, which is on October the 6th. And Sheffield United have a little bit of a similar playing style to Liverpool in that they are high pressing, very aggressive, and as stated in the report, this is believed to play a role in convincing Jurgen Klopp that Brewster will be in good hands. Chris Wilder is very, very knowledgeable, very good manager. And one Liverpool, if the Brewster is sold, but he has a reasonable buyback clause, then it's effectively just a loan deal with Liverpool getting a short-term funds to play with, and he's okay with that. Another fan said that if these Brewster to Sheffield United rumors for around 20-25 million pounds are true, because at the start of the summer it was expected that Ryan Brewster would leave on loan, but now it looks like Liverpool need to generate some funds, and Brewster is a very hot prospect right now on the back of his brilliant loan spell at Swansea. He scored 11 goals in 22 games, and also in preseason he scored 3 goals in 2 games. And Liverpool really like Ismail Assar from Watford, and we really want to make that transfer happen, but we have to sell some players to fund that for transfer. And if that player is Ryan Brewster, and if Jurgen Klopp thinks that Brewster, of course he wants to play first team football, and he won't get that probably at Liverpool. Origi is ahead of him in the pecking order. Minamino is ahead of him in the pecking order. Maybe even Shadan Shaqiri. So Brewster right now is like 7th in terms of the attackers pecking order at Liverpool. And he wants first team football. He's a very ambitious guy. So I think it's best for all parties if Brewster leaves Liverpool. And if there is no other way to generate enough funds to bring in the likes of Ismail Assar and Thiago, then I'm all for selling Brewster right now and maybe getting him back in 2 or 3 years. The big debate is whether Brewster will be so upset with Liverpool that we sold him that he might refuse to come back in 3 years' time. But we don't know the personal conversations that will go on between Jurgen Klopp and Brewster. If Jurgen Klopp guarantees Brewster that when he comes back, if he improves and he comes back, he will get regular playing time, then Brewster might be welcoming to that idea. So of course the original plan was to sell Grujic, Harry Wilson and Shaqiri to fund the transfers like Ismail Assar and Thiago. But it looks like that many clubs are hit so hard by this pandemic and the financial crisis that they just cannot afford to pay the transfer fees that Liverpool want. We want 20 million for Grujic, 20 million for Harry Wilson, maybe even 25 million for Shaqiri and Brewster. and not many clubs can pay that amount, it looks like. So we have to adapt to the situation and alter our transfer strategy a little bit. And I want to share the thoughts of Sunday World journalist Kevin Palmer, who actually said some very interesting things about Liverpool's transfer strategy. But first, he talked about Liverpool's last season, where we won the title. One of the best seasons we have ever seen in English football, as simple as that. To have the record Liverpool had up to the Watford game was legendary stuff, and even if they failed to maintain the momentum, this team should be recognized as all-time great, up there with all the best Liverpool teams. I work with John Aldridge every week and he agrees with me on this. If Liverpool can add a couple of Premier League titles and maybe one more Champions League, then this will be the best Liverpool team ever in their history. Jurgen Klopp and Liverpool have been clear that they will not spend money that they do not have. Unlike clubs with sugar daddy owners, Liverpool cannot dip into the reserves of an old rich state and sign players like Messi. That is frustrating for Jurgen Klopp and for the fans, and eventually it could undermine Liverpool's ambitions because with the financial fair play now seemingly defunct, Man City, Chelsea, Paris Saint-Germain will clearly have a big advantage over the traditional football clubs. And Palmer also said, Liverpool are good enough to win one of the big trophies this season. I see this Liverpool team winning trophies for the next 4 or 5 years if they keep all the key parts together. Salah is the one who might look to move on at some point, but no one can afford Liverpool's best players this summer and they would be mad to leave this great team. It doesn't get any better than this. Liverpool probably should have signed Timo Werner, but the money was too much for them with agents, fees, wages. That could have been a perfect solution to the forward line, even though Minamino has looked good in preseason. I interviewed Rio Ferdinand a couple of weeks back and he thinks Liverpool could be exposed if some of their key men are out for a long period, and Werner would have added to the forward options. They also need another centre back, and I would like to see a creative midfielder coming in. Thiago fits the bill. And I can't wait for the Chelsea-Liverpool game. Kurt Zouma, the Chelsea defender, spiced things up a little bit ahead of that game, saying that Liverpool have a great front three, but we also have our weapons. We can hurt Liverpool. It will be a great game to watch. Last season, Liverpool completely dominated the season. They had a great run of wins. They hardly lost. But this is another year, a new season. Everybody starts from zero, and we will see what we can do. And that's the beauty of football. Every season, every team starts from zero, and you can always rely on last season to get confidence. But that counts for nothing in terms of results. You have to prove on the pitch that you are good enough to win the title again. And I think that is going to be the hardest thing to do, because winning a title for the first time is probably easier than winning it again 2 times in a row. And only the very, very special teams can do that. And I really hope that Liverpool can prove to be a very, very special team. They already proved it with a 97 and 99 point season. But I think that Jurgen Klopp is working hard to add to this squad, because he realized that Liverpool needs a little bit of fresh signings, new signings. Ismail Assar and Thiago would be the perfect 2 new signings for Liverpool. So hopefully we can sell the likes of Harry Wilson, Grujic and Brewster and fund those 2 transfers. I'm really excited for the rest of the season. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed this. Have a nice day. See you later. Goodbye.